I would like to call Mahathir to the question.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر هي حتى مطلع الفجر. صدق الله العظيم.
السلام عليكم and a very good afternoon to all of you. I am here on behalf of EBA semester 3 class. I would like to welcome you all here for the first round of value action test. Before giving introduction to our today's respected guest, today's teacher is going to conduct our session. First, I would like to share the purpose of conducting this value addition session. In view of the line, ethical and moral standards, where the fine line between right and wrong has been almost destroyed, I think feels that a major step to address this organ composition of value is to address the problem at grassroots level by transferring the concept of ethics and morality to the students and to develop their vision as to what is right and what is wrong. For this purpose, it is planned that after every 10 hours of formal teaching of a subject, a young personality like a today's guest will be invited to talk to the student from an ethical point of view regarding a particular subject in order to add value to their life. Today we have the greatest honor of having Mr. MMS Feroz with us for this valuable session. He is our teacher also. And he thinks that rather than inviting someone from outside, he will tell us the why Mr. MMS Feroz to start his session.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for this invitation, for sharing some concepts of numbers regarding our practical life and the ethical point of view regarding our universe. The first thing I want to tell you about, it is the last ayat of Surah Al-Jin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I quote, وَأَحْسَى كُلَّ شَيْءٍ عَدَلًا. There can be many meanings to this, right? One of them can be that anything, everything, all the things are being covered by numbers. Asa is used to say to cover. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Jin, of course it is in the context of that when Jibreel is bringing wahi to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then it is the scene is shown in such a way that a real elegant message is coming, and right and left, front and behind is being guarded, and it is guarded in such a way that nothing can be taken away from it or nothing can be included in that, and there can never be a fault in that message. This is the basic concept of say the if you read Surah Al-Jin, then at the end they say, وَأَحْسَى كُلَّ شَيْءٍ عَدَلًا. And everything is being covered by numbers. So in my opinion, number plays a very important role in our life. Just to, as a say, out of brevity I can say, that numbers were created before the creation of the universe. The reason behind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He created this universe Well, what is the meaning of days? That is another debate. But whatever it is, 6 days, it can be six times or six something. But definitely, when Rasulullah says that he created this universe in 6 days, it means the number six was already being created. Otherwise, how it will be counted that 6 days have passed? So numbers, the creation of numbers is similar to the creation of the universe. But before the universe was created, numbers were created. I am not saying that numbers were the first which was created, but what I am saying that numbers were created before the creation of universe. That is for sure, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says clearly that he created this universe before in 6 days. And then of course it is also explained that in 2 days this thing was created, and 1 day that thing was created, etc. All the details are in the Quran and in the Quran. What I am saying that numbers have the importance that not only they are senior, the creation of numbers is senior to the creation of universe. At the same time, today, when we see these computers, when we write a word, anybody who is computer trained must be knowing that we write A, then there is an ASCII code of A. There is an ASCII code of A, and that is in binary. 010100, etc. I think people are knowing better than me that when we write A, B, C, D alphabets, then the alphabets are not alphabets in the language of computer. Alphabets are in the form of numbers, binary numbers. So numbers are converted to alphabets by the machine, and they appear as A, B, C, D on the screen, but basically they are numbers. So numbers are very important, and there is of course in Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ma yalfiz min qawlin ladayhi raqeebun atheeb." Whatever you utter in the Arabic, the word nafs. Nafs is the literal meaning of the lafz is to throw. The literal meaning is the lafz. Nafs means to throw. So when you throw a word from your mouth, when you throw a word from your mouth, ما يلفظ من قول لدي رقيب عظيم. رقيب is in Arabic means the one نجبان, you can say. And عظيم, the one who is very carefully guarding. A guarding, somebody who is guarding very carefully. Whatever you throw from your mouth, somebody is guarding. There is a guard, رقيب عظيم, who is noting it. What you are throwing from your mouth. What you are throwing from your mouth, it is being recorded. And it is, and you know that recording of is always in numbers, as you can see at the lower level. At the higher level, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we don't know it. But at our level, we understand that what appears to be a word is numbers. So whenever we throw a word from our mouth, then we speak a word. Throw means, in the actual meaning, when we speak a word from our mouth, then it is being recorded by very careful guardians. And then it will be presented to us. Then again I will say, another one of the Swan of Quran says in Surah Yasin, وَإِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْءٍ وَإِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْءٍ أَنْ يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. And Swan of Quran says that when he wants to create something, then he utters. Sir, is there any? So when Swan of Quran says when he wants to create something, then he utters a word. And then from the word, creation starts. Of course, he could have said, وَإِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا فَهُوْ يَكُونُ. He can create without uttering a word. He just imagines and things are created. But he links creation with the utterance of word. Unless a word is spoken, things are not created. And the same thing, of course, the only creator, the actual creator is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the human level, when we create an idea, the idea remains nothing unless we convert that idea into words. If it remains in your mind, it has no value, it is not being created. Once you convert your idea into words, and then it is a meaningful thing. And then you utter it in the form of your mouth, or it is being written, of course it is utterance, and then it is being recorded, because you are at a certain level, you are there in the creation process. You are creating something, and therefore, whatever you utter, you are responsible for the creation. and of course at the Yom Kiyamah, when Allah say, did you do that thing or that thing or that thing, and if one person will deny, تُقَلِّبُنَا عَيْدِهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ الْأَرْجُلُهُمْ. His hands, تَقُلُ اللَّهُ النَّذِي أَنْتَقَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. He has given me the power to speak as he has given power to speak to other things also. So I am also speaking because of that power. Concluding that, if I am saying that words uttered, there are numbers behind them. There are numbers behind them, and numbers are the most important creation of the universe, created before the creation of the universe. And then there is a little technical thing I am saying. There is a theorem in mathematics. I am not going to quote the theorem, that is a technical thing, but it says that anything which can be counted, the measure of that counted thing is zero. And when we in mathematics we say counted, then it means it is equal to the number of natural numbers. When a thing is equal to the number of natural numbers, then it is called counted. It can be counted. Once a thing is in one-to-one correspondence with the natural numbers, then it is called counted. So counted things, the measure of counted things is zero. This is a theorem of mathematics. Measure of countable set is zero. So, Mamakhaya Dunya, illa ta'ala. This, all the things of this world, they are nothing but haru. Haru is a word which is used to deceiving people. It is a deceit. Whatever is there in the world, it is all deceiving. Mamakhaya Dunya, illa ta'ala. You see, people, genius people. Mir was a great poet, and he said, marvelous. He said, I hope I read it correctly. ये तफाहुम का कारण है, यहाँ वही है जो बार किया. ये तफाहुम का कारण है, यहाँ वही है जो बार किया. So whatever we believe in, whatever we conceive, I'm not saying believe is a slightly different word. I am very careful what you know that word. Whatever we conceive, we call it truth. But what is truth? The truth is only what we believe for us. What is actual truth? Well, that is again a thing for. I cannot enter into that I'll be deviating from my lecture. But what I am again coming back is that anything can be numbered. And all words, words speak, and all creations. Because creations are after the word, and word is a number. So all creations are numbered. And then creations are creations, they are numbered, and even if they are equal to the number of natural numbers, they are measures. Once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, just finish and everything is finished. And when he wants to create, he creates. And otherwise, there is nothing unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants it to be. Anyway, I just want to show you I hope you will enjoy that. We are living in this world, which is a part of this bigger thing, which is called universe. In this universe, there is a solar system. There is a solar system, everybody knows that. The solar system, and this is something like that. This is an approximate view of solar system. It's not exactly. There is a sun somewhere, and Earth, and Jupiter, and all other planets, rotating, somebody agrees, they are circling, elliptical or circular, semi-circular things around and around for millions and millions of years. And this poor Earth, we are residing on this Earth, it is also circling around this sun. And of course, sometimes it is near, sometimes it is away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so kind to us that when Earth comes near to the sun, then the sun is trying to suck it because of the force of gravity. And then, because of the force of gravity, the sun is trying to suck it into it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase the speed of Earth. Automatically it will decrease. and the speed increases, and therefore the sun will not be able to suck up heat. And when it is away from the sun, and if the speed remains the same, then it will go into the space, and sun will not be able to hold it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decrease the speed. So at every step, the speed of Earth is controlled, very, very tightly controlled, and it is increasing and decreasing, increasing and decreasing in such a way that it is neither going to the space, nor it is being sucked by the sun, otherwise nothing will remain. And similarly, other planets, the same thing happening. They are circling, kullun fi falakin yas'un, everything is circling in their own orbit. And then, this is our sun. It's a big thing. 9 crore miles away, rises and takes some minutes till the light reaches. And the thing is that when we compare the dimensions of the planets are, this is our Earth. And this is Jupiter, that is Saturn, that is Neptune, and that is Pluto. And this is the comparative dimension of the planets which are making the solar system of the sun. And then the comparison of these planets to the sun is like that. This is our sun, giving us light and heat. All the light, depending on light and heat given by the sun. And then this Earth. This spot is the Earth. So you can imagine how many millions of Earth can be embedded into the sun, which is that big. And then Jupiter is as big as you can see here. So this is a comparative dimensions of different planets which are circling around the Earth. Poor Pluto is that dot, small dot. This is a slightly bigger Earth, and then of course Jupiter, etc. And this sun, when these astronauts they go into the space, they saw a strange phenomenon. They said a whole sun equal to sun, a sort of heated something is coming out of the sun. And then it is spreading. That is heat of the sun. After a few seconds or few minutes, again the same amount of heat moves and then it goes into the space to heat these planets and give life and whatever is needed. Anyway, if we cross the planetary system, this our planetary system, and we start moving into the space. And we start moving into the space after. This is the sun, circling. And then if we meet that all the planets and still continue our journey in the space, and if we are moving with the speed of light, and we are moving, which is nearly impossible, if we are moving with a velocity of 1,06,000 miles per second, then after four years, we will meet another sun. The name of this sun is Cyrus. In Quran, the name of this Cyrus is written Rabbu Shira. The Shira is a star, which is basically a sun. And Arabs, the Burqaras, the idol worshippers, used to worship this Cyrus, which is called Shira. So Rabbu Shira. So this is, if you look at the velocity of light, after 4 years, you will see another sun, and definitely there must be some planets, some. And if you continue your journey, by the way, NASA is planning to send a mission to Cyrus in 2015. That will go to Cyrus, near to Cyrus, circle it, come back to Earth, and it will take 32 years. It will take 32 years to go to Cyrus and come back and check if there are planets, inhabitable planets, or nothing like that, but they want to check it. And they are sending 32 years to take to go to Cyrus and come back. And of course, 4 light years, which is quite a distance. And then if you continue your journey in the light, in the skies, there is another spot. And if you continue your journey for 50 years with velocity of light, the velocity of light, 1,06,000 miles per second, and continue for 50 years, you will meet another sun, which is called Pollux. The Pollux is as big to sun as you can see, and definitely you are not going to compare the Earth on this deck, poor Earth, which is circling the sun over here. Then this is Pollux. Then if you continue your journey for 100 years, light years, you meet another sun. We call it, and the sun is in the night, you can see spot. God is there in the skies, and with the binocular, you can really see, be able to see. Arcturus with naked eyes is not possible, it was so distant away, and that is Arcturus. 1,000 light years, I'm sorry I said 500, 1,000 light years, and the thing is, oh my God, we never, people, something I happen to remember, there was lobster, regarding the lobster, and this is, oh, let me find it, oh, here is sun, not visible, Cyrus is, this is what? Oh, this is Pollux, Arcturus, little, Alpenton, Betelgeuse, and Tellus. And Tellus is a sun in the space. Few, I am not exactly known, but I see that. 10,000 light years, or something more than that. If you travel with the speed of light, 10,000 years, you will meet a sun which is called Antares, and this Antares is quite nicely visible in the night. And we never people, we used to take direction for this in the night. When we want to locate our place in the ocean, then we locate it by the help of Antares. Antares is so big that if you bring this Antares and put it at the place of our sun, the periphery of Antares will touch not only Earth, it will cross Earth. The periphery of Earth, the dimension of Antares is so big, you can imagine how many million sun can be embedded. And how many millions can be embedded in our sun? So you can imagine how big this Antares. If you put Antares in place of our sun, it will cross Earth, it will go near to Jupiter. But it will be very, very, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is keeping them so distant away. And the distance, the hugeness, is in the night, there is a spot, a glittering spot in the night, that is Antares. And then, this is not the end of the story. The thing is that if we, excuse me, you're saying something?
Yeah,
I mean, these things are, this is not imagination. These are all can be seen by anybody. And anyway, I don't want to, I may be influenced by saying a thing which I have to say afterwards, but anyway, these are the things which can be observed by anybody. This is not hypothetical. This is not a story. This is anybody. And in Chile, you see, in Chile, at the height of 5,000 meters in Chile, they have established a astronomical lab, and there are 36 binoculars, astronomical binoculars, which are radio binoculars, and then they are focusing in the skies. 36, and at the height of 5,000 meters, clean air, nothing disturbed in Chile, and that is being, it is a consortium which has made that lab, and they have observed very, very strange phenomena which is happening. And which was, you must have read in Dawn, about a week back, there was, not in Dawn, BBC News, there was a news that what is happening in this space. 75 billion light years. Oh, if the light travels 75 Arab sound, 75 billion light years. Billion means? Million means 160. And billion means? 12 zeros. This is 1 billion. And then if the light travels 75 billion light years, and that was seen by that binoculars over there, which is fixed in Chile at the height of 5,000 meters, and they saw, they witnessed the two galaxies were colliding. Two galaxies were colliding, and the universe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so huge that we do not know it, that it is happening. It happened, and definitely the light has reached today with us. So it happened 75 billion light years before. Anyway, just the hugeness I want to show. Let me not be misguided by the influence. So this is what we have seen, and then this is not the end of the story with the entire. What I want to show you is something more strange. And this is, let me have another slide for you.
Fine.
You see? This is our sun. And here is science. 4 light years. And here is science. The nearest star from sun. Then this length is equal to 10 light years. And then, as I showed to you before, when I move further, and here we are. This is our sun. And then other, this gap is a part of 1500 most luminous stars within 250, you see, space is so huge. We measure the distances in terms of light year. 1 light year is the distance, is the length, is the distance. When light covers in 1 year, that is called 1 light year. So the universe is so huge that we cannot count it in terms of kilometers or miles. We measure it in terms of light year. The distance traveled by light in 1 year is called 1 light year. So this is sun, and then this is other different stars over here. This galactic region, I must talk about this also. But before going to that, let me have this. You see, this is our Betelgeuse. This is Betelgeuse. This is, and then this stars, all these 520 spots are stars. Stars. Betelgeuse, our poor sun. Oh, somewhere over here. And around this poor sun, there is a revolving. And we are sitting on that sun, moving, and fighting from the branch of the tree. That who shall be the master of this branch? Who shall be the master of the branch? And we fight to death. We fight to death that who shall be the master of this branch? Who shall be the master of this piece of desert? Who shall be the master of that house? Who shall be the master of that road? Or who shall be the master of that? This over here. Betelgeuse. If you put this Betelgeuse in place of sun, it will reach the periphery, it will reach not only Earth, it will go to Jupiter. And then this dust-like thing is suns and suns and millions of suns. Then this collection is called Orion Arm, O-R-I-N, Orion Arm, and our sun is in the Orion Arm. Similar to Orion Arm, there is a Sagittarius Arm. In the Sagittarius Arm, it is far bigger than our Orion. Perseus Arm is smaller, but again, billions of suns. And this is 4,000 light years. 4,000 light years, and then from one corner to another corner, 4,000 light years. If you travel from one place to another place, it's 4,000 light years, and the distance you can see, this is 1,000, this distance between the two arms is 1,000 light years approximately. Thanks to the solar, that our sun is not in Sagittarius now. Otherwise, the heat is too intense, and the stars are so heated that nothing can survive over there. Our sun over here. And the galaxies, the collection of stars, clusters of stars, oh my God. And then this is over here. Some, they are moving this way, they move this way also. Sometimes it so happens that this central part is moving up. And at the same time, this our Orion Arm is also moving up. In millions of years, it can happen that the time in the center of this that's known universe is at the level of Orion Arm is a huge electromagnetic storm. And all of our electronic equipment fail. And all communications break down. Because it is very rare that it is also up and our Orion Arm is up to the same level and we receive so many. But anyway, just coming. Oh, all these things. The universe, 500,000 light years, 500,000, 500, 1,000, 500 times light years. And this is the whole of Orion Arms, Sagittarius Arm, Sagittarius Arm, and then this is called Milky Way. And this Milky Way, and this is a spot in the universe. This is a spot in the universe. Then this is 100 million light years. This one spot is the whole Milky Way. The one spot, and this is all being seen. This is not hypothetical. This is all being seen. And then it was observed in let me show you the slide, and then I shall, they say, this is written over there, universe with 1 billion light years. I'm sorry, my galaxy is lost in this desert of stars. I have to look into it. Where is Perseus arm, and where is the Orion arm, and in Orion arm, there is somewhere my spark, an invisible spark is my sun, and around the sun, the poor earth, and on the poor earth, when I look at the sun, I'm asking, what a till this time, 75 billion light years, we have discovered many, many suns and their planets, and everything, as science students are doing, that everything, it emits a sort of spectrum. I'm giving my spectrum, this thing is giving us a spectrum, and it is going into the form of waves. Till this time, we have not discovered a spectrum which is similar to a human spectrum, living being spectrum from the universe. Till this time, no spectrum is being seen which can be interpreted as a spectrum of living being. All these things which we have discovered till this time, they are the spectrum of sodium, of calcium, of iron, of this and that, but not of human, not of a living being. Till this time, maybe who knows, there is after 75, and people used to think that the universe, this was the early imagination, 14 billion light years. And then last year there was a news that there was an explosion, a qiyamah you can call it, at a distance of 35 billion light years. Then it was abundant, that this space is limited to 14 billion light years. It was abundant. That last year I was talking, just 15 days back, it was on BBC, they said, sorry, we are mistaken. The space we have seen now up to 75 billion light years, where two galaxies were colliding and the stars were forming in formation. And then when the galaxy collides, sometimes it happens that because of the collision, the force is so intense that the whole galaxy is squeezed to a ball, like a football. And the gravity of that ball is so huge that anything enters into it, nothing never goes out. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, Jahannam, Limtalat, are you filled? Are you full? Say, Halim Mazir, is there anything left? Nothing comes out of that. Nothing comes out of that. So that is named in science language, is called black hole. If one black hole randomly walks and comes to our galaxy, one gulf, one luma, if one black hole comes near to our galaxy, it will eat it like that as we eat one another. It will be nowhere. And there are millions and millions of black holes wandering in the universe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all these are counted. They can be billions or millions, but they can be counted. And counted takes millions. If we go out of the box and see how the box is, because the box is three-dimensional box, and we are in the three-dimensional box. Unless we go out of the three-dimensional box, we cannot say what this box is. We can see it from inside. We cannot go outside. So this is all that is 25 million. And then we are deceived always. You see, we say, when you put a bell, electric bell in a jar, and close it, and when you break it, the current pass, it rings, and you can hear it. You take out the air from the jar, and you do not hear the ringing of the bell. You say, therefore we imply that sound needs a medium to travel. Okay? So there is no medium, sound cannot travel. Okay, light travels without medium. Nonsense. There is always a medium. We can say the light is traveling in a space. That space we call it nothing. But that nothing Now it is established that we call nothing which we call ether or something. That is the actual way that there was a first slide which I did not show. 99.9% weight is of that nothing. Only 0.0001% is the weight of this all galaxies and stars and superstars and everything. And then Allah says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Insan, this is created at the best of the age. Allah knows that why he has created and what is that. And then he is so kind. He is so kind that when you take nibara and you want to eat something, then Allah subhanahu wa takes care of that. Sends the messages. You can call it anything, but there are his powers. And they close the lid. The food, when you put it on the tongue, then it goes over the air tunnel. There's a lid which closes the air tunnel. And then it moves over the air tunnel. And behind that, there is a tunnel which is going to our stomach. It is tightly closed. Water, food moves over it, goes into there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not saying, do it yourself. He is doing it himself or us. He's so kind because of our own mistake. Sometimes when we are eating and we speak, then there is a question of life and death. Uchulata, this is called. You cannot, this is something which somebody can be killed because of that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so careful when we are breathing, the air, there is air comes, there is a membrane, two membranes of our lungs. One part is blood, one part is air. The air passes through membrane. Unless we spoil it by doing something injurious to it, that is, we put tar on it, we put smoke on it, we put smoke of cigarettes on it, then it is tarred and the air is not easily passing through the membrane, and therefore it will not clean the blood which is again going into the body. Subhanallah, it's all praises to Allah. But I am saying that imagine coming back 75 million light years, come back to our sun, then to the earth, and then to the person, the human beings which are living over here. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if the leaf of a tree falls, it is recorded. Character region, I said that I must say something. The earth was created, and I am quoting the authority of Sayyid Qutb, explanation of the Quran. When the earth was created, it was formed in the form of heated ball of fire. There was no question of water. Then there are galactic regions in the space. Galactic regions are the ice of the dimension of like moon or etc. They are guided towards earth and they collided with earth. When those ice mountains collided with earth, then it was converted into water. And then they vaporize, and then they again fell down, then again fell down, and the upper core 50 miles is cooled, and on which we are buried. And all our working is with reference to that 50. Inside it is still that hot lava is inside there, and then that water was given to us. That's the ration which was given to us in the beginning. No more water. That water goes to the rivers, to the seas, that rises, then in the form of the sky, in the form of the snow or rain, then again we use it, again goes to the space. 1 square mile, 1 inch rain, not vehicle, some 200 million gallons of water. I'm not sure, I read it, sir, I've forgotten that. 1 square mile, 1 inch rain brings some million gallons of water which is suspended in the air. If you hold one, you cannot hold a drop of water in the air, but some billion gallons of water in the space. Subhanallah, we all praise to Allah and that is my praise. Thank you very much. I am very honored for this talk. Any question? Anybody has? I shall be honored. when the galaxies collide, then they are compressed mass. It's so compressed a mass that the whole galaxy can be compressed into a ball. It is something what is calculated, which cannot be seen by naked eyes, but it is being calculated because the rays which are coming, they are somewhere intercepted in such a way that they do not go beyond that. So we call them black. Black hole is such a gravitational force, nothing can go out of that. Nothing goes in, cannot go out. This is called black. This is something. And this is his mohi, his ilm, and his power, his creation, his powers are mohi on all of these things, and this is what we know. What is real out of the box of this three dimension? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any question, please? Anybody else? Thank you very much. Thank you very much, please. Sir, it's honor for me, Dr. Sareem, that you are here. And sir, thank you very much for being here. It's my honor. I hope that if there is something not correct, I accept. Dr. Sareem, sir, I expect that you please point it out and correct it. Thank you very much for that.
Hope you all enjoyed this lively session and had a good learning experience with our wonderful guest and teacher. In the end, I would like to thank our guest speaker, faculty, management and students for attending this session with attention. A very special thanks again to Mr. M.M. Firoz for conducting this value-added session. Now, for giving a token of appreciation, I request my class to give a huge round of applause to the